And welcome back, guys. This is going to be a new series I'm starting. Well, it's more of a segment, not really a series, I guess. But that's besides the point. Where basically I'll go over cards, decks, structure decks, maybe a tin here and there, a combo that two cards have synergy with, and I'll go over it from a noob standpoint, where it's more relatable, I guess, than a more advanced Yugi player going, "Well, it's not MacRabbit or Mindups. It sucks." Then again, I play Dark Worlds, so I guess I'm a hypocrite. But I play Dark Worlds to be competitive. I bring extra decks to have fun. That makes more sense to me. Like, oh, I'm in a tournament, I'm gonna bring in a good deck, so the point of a tournament is to win, not to, bring a bad deck and lose, I guess. Excuse me, I'm getting over being sick and I have a lot of, well, gross, really, really gross phlegm. But yeah, so I do play Dark Worlds. I mean, yeah, I'm that guy that plays Dark Worlds, but I mean, I like Dark Worlds. I like Six Samurais better, but I feel like I need more cards. I only have one Kizan, and you need two more. I need two more, and I don't have a lot of the cards, so I need to get more cards. So I'm running Dark Worlds for now. But anyways, I'm getting off track here. The point of this is I'm gonna go over cards from a new standpoint, where it's more I go to see what's good, what's not good, what you should use, what you shouldn't use. But it's basically from a noob standpoint where it's kind of more relatable. Where it's like, oh, okay, I mean, obviously he doesn't know what he's talking about, but it makes some sense when he says it. So there's that. Let me adjust my mic real quick. There we go. I mean, it sounds kind of loud because I can hear feedback through the headphones. But anyways, so obviously we're going over Madolches. Madolches are awesome. They're food related. I'm not sure if the people are food or they just stand on food. It's like really weird. I mean, I guess they have food. Whether or not they are food is. Are they food? Are they like little marshmallow? I mean, their names are food. Right? Anyway, that's confusing. So basically, I'm gonna go over the archetype of Madolches for the most part. A general build I run. I mean, I'm no pro deck building. This is generally what I run. And then some other cards you could potentially run if you feel like it. I mean, it's not like, oh, this is the best. It's not. It's not even close to the best. It's close to the best because I am the best. I'm not the best. Moving on. So basically, okay, Madolches have an overarching effect. I'm not sure if any other cards have like any archetype as an overarching effect minus Gladiator Beasts because I know they have their tag out ability. But basically, what a Madolche does is when this card in your possession is destroyed by your opponent's card, either by battle or by card effect, and sent to your graveyard, shuffle this card into your deck. All the monsters have this effect. The fields, the spell cards, and the trap cards do not. So just keep that in mind. So, what that effect means is if this card gets well, actually, not bottomless, because it does not go to the graveyard. If this card gets attacked over, Mirror Force, just generally destroyed by anything that your opponent controls, not that you control. You cannot dark hole your own Madolches and they go back to the deck, because you control the card. But all three of those, they get shuffled into the deck instead, unless you're running the Field Spell, which we'll get into later. Another thing that was, I think, recently changed with Madolches is if they are Solemned, either Judgment or Warnings, they go into the deck, because they are in your possession. Now, a question for me is, because I have no clue, if they are card destruction. Yeah, they are sent to the graveyard. But I don't think they're destroyed, so I'm not sure if it works like that. That's a weird ruling. I have no clue personally. I think they would be, because they are in your possession, but they're not destroyed, if that makes sense. I have no clue. But anyway, so the point of this is, okay, so let's go over Madolches real quick. Let's go over the overarching cards, and then we'll go. This is new for me. I'm trying to get used to this, so I'm just gonna use this first video as like a starting point, and then get better at it as I go. So basically, let's go over all the Madolche cards, and then we'll go over cards you should use to health Madolches out. So let's go over Butlerusk. Butlerusk is when this card is normal summoned, add a field spell card to your hand. You're gonna add Chateau. We'll go over Chateau in a bit, but you're gonna add Chateau. You could run Seal of Orichalcos, but Chateau is a lot better. A lot better, actually. So, I mean, it's an option. I wouldn't write it out, but we're definitely run three Chateaus. If you can fit in, Seal of Orichalcos, go for it. I mean, it wouldn't be bad, since you can add it with Butlerusk. But you need to control a face-up Madolche monster on the field to activate and to resolve this effect. So if, like, oh, you have Butler Usk, and if you have two Butler Usks, one gets booked, you don't have another face-up. That's just, it makes more sense to me. You don't get to go, oh, I had a field spell. Anyways, so that's Butler Usk. We have now have Madolche, Crufsan. All Madolche monsters have the same ability, as I said before, but their secondary effect is different. There are no normal Madolche monsters, which I think is good, because I think vanillas are terrible. I don't like vanillas, unless you're running Rabbit, of course, and then vanillas are amazing if they're level 4. But besides the point, once per turn, you can target one face-up Madolche card you control, accept this card, return to the hand, and if you do, increase this card's level by 1 and attack by 300. So basically, what that means, if you control another Madolche, either Continuous Trap or Spell Card, you can bounce it back to your hand, and then this card will gain 1 level, so it'll be level 4. And 300 attack, so we level 4 with 1800, which is decent for level 4, so it makes sense. This card's amazing with a little sort of combo you can do, but the greatest thing about Crufsan is, and this is why I run a general Crufsan build, is that the boost lasts forever. The boost does not end at the end phase, so it'll stay level 4 and 18 till forever, until the card leaves the field. So if you bounce back your own Crufsan, it's back at level 3 with 1500. If that makes sense. It should make sense. So that's Crufsan. Very good card. That card's amazing. It's a little baby puppy. It's a puppy. Baby puppy is redundant. Besides the point. Up next is the Sword of Floater. It's Magellin. Normal summon Magellin or flip summon. So you can set it and then flip it. Obviously you're gonna normal summon. Why would you ever flip summon something if you don't have to? You can add one Madolche monster from your deck to your hand. So that's pretty good. Hey, you run 3. It's like a Stratos without the secondary effect, which is pretty good. I mean, Madolches aren't very good meta-wise, so I doubt they'll drop that down to 2. Unless they do something with Madolches that makes them drop it down to 2, but I don't think they could do anything. Moving on to Marmamate. This card, I think, had a name change, I believe. It's now Marmalade. 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 It's like Marmalade. But anyways, when this card is flipped face up, you can target one Madolche spell or trap card in your graveyard and add that target to your hand. So you set it, gets flipped face up, by attacking, or you flip it, doesn't matter. But if it's Darkhold, it obviously doesn't get flipped face up. So and you get a spell trap card from the graveyard, which is all right. It's the reason why I only run two, because it's not, too good. It's not like Messen Gelato, which means this card is special summoned. You can add one Madolche spell or trap card from your deck to your hand, which is a lot better because it deck thins as well. But you have to control a face up beast type, which is good because Mifel's effect, when this card is normal summoning, special summon a Madolche monster from your hand. So you go Mifel, Messen Gelato, add a field spell, go for field spell, boom. Only problem Mifel, it's only 500. And that's an issue. That's like you have to normal summon in attack mode, and then you have to figure out a way to defend it. Because unless you're gonna take a huge hit, because it really can't stand up much. Unless there's like a, I don't know. There's not a lot you can do with it. I mean, it's great because it gets out Messen Gelato. Messen Gelato gets his effects, but that's about it. I mean, and you can't combo with Butler Usk. I mean, but yeah, Butler Usk, because this card has to be normal summon to get the field spell. But this card can get the field spell. But I don't know. It just seems like if this card could be special summoned, it'd be better with Mifel. Sorta. I mean, it's not like, oh, it's so much better, but I mean, it would make it better. Because then if you just special this guy, he doesn't get its effect, so it's kind of like pointless at that point. It's like a normal at that point. Anyways, and then let's go over Chateau real quick. When this card's activated, shuffle all Madolche monsters in your graveyard into the deck. All Madolche monsters on the field gain 500 attack and defense, which is amazing. The cards don't have that much attack and defense. But the 500 boost is phenomenal, especially with Madolches. I think the highest guy is Chevalier with 17, so the highest guy you can get it out is 22, unless you're running Pudding Cess, but I'll go over Pudding Cess in a little bit. There are other Madolche cards, but not all of them are good. I guess I can go over all of them. I just want to go over the main cards, go over some extra cards you can run, and then go over the extra deck. Okay, so Chateau, and then the secondary effect is what makes this card amazing. If a monster in your graveyard would be returned to the deck by the effect of a Madolche monster, you can add it to your hand instead. So basically, if Madoche Butlerusk gets destroyed by your opponent's card effect. Let's say you Dark Soul your Butlerusk for whatever reason, goes to the graveyard. Instead of shuffling it into the deck, it goes right to your hand because it's the effect of a Madoche card. Other card, I don't. I think the only card, other card that does that is the XYZ monster. Oop, my bad. Is the XYZ monster that can? It has to be by a monster effect, I believe. By the effect of a Madoche, yeah. So there's not a lot of cards that bring it. Wait. Yeah, it has to be from your graveyard to the deck. By effect, Madoche can add it to your hand instead. So it's good. I mean, if you can figure out a way to get cards from your deck to your hand. I mean, your graveyard to your deck that we can add to your hand. So it's you never really go minus per se with this card on the field, as long as your opponent destroys it. And then Ticket, which Ticket is basically it's like Black Whirlwind. Let me bring up Black Whirlwind for you guys. Not everybody. Yeah, I guess I should type. Black Whirlwind, which is at one. When a Blackwing monster is normal summoned to your side of the field, you can add one Blackwing monster from your deck to your hand that has less attack than that monster. Now, this to me says, okay, Ticket's definitely gonna go down to two, or one. Definitely. Let's go over Ticket so you can understand why. When Madoche card is returned from your side of the field or graveyard to your hand or main deck by a card effect, add one Madoche monster from your deck to your hand. If you control a face-up Fairy-type Madoche monster, you can special summon that the monster from your deck in face-up attack position instead of adding it to your hand. You can only see the effect of Madoche Ticket once per turn. So basically, Butlerusk, destroy graveyard deck, add a Madoche, add another Butlerusk, go for whatever you want. Graveyard hand, you have Chateau, add another Madoche. You control a fairy. The only fairy there is Pudding Cess and I believe Tiramisu. Yes, so if you're not running Pudding Cess in your builds, you're not going to get many uses out of special summoning. But if you compare tickets to Black Whirlwind is less and Black Whirlwind is at one. Because Ticket lets you add one and then has a chance to special summon one. I mean, it's like you can add anything. You can add Pudding Cess, you can add Messenger Lotto, you can add Moifel. It doesn't matter what it is, you can add it, as long as it's Madolche. So I think this card will definitely go down to two or one. If Madolche see a lot more play, obviously. I mean, this card's amazing. It's better than Black Whirlwind, in my opinion. I have no clue what I'm talking about. The other two cards are Madolche Palooza, which used to be Madolche Happy Festa. Special any number of Madolche monsters from your hand, but shuffle them into the deck during the end phase. So basically, you can special summon any number from your hand. I just did. Not sure why I'm telling you that. I just said that. Let me see. So this might combo with Ticket. Yep. So if you have Madolche Palooza, you special summon, say two Crevsaunts, and they go back into the deck at the end phase. You Ticket activates. So you get to add a card with Ticket. I believe so, but I have no clue. Tea Break. Tea Break is amazing. Tea Break is so good. You might think it's not good, but I think it's good. When a spell and trap card is activated, if you have no monsters in your graveyard, negate the activation. If you do, return to the hand. Then, if you control a phase of Madolche Pudding Cess, you can destroy one card your opponent controls. This is more for the Pudding Cess build. I left it in here. It's still good. You rarely have cards in your graveyard, unless you're running Birdman, but I'll get that in a second. So basically, let's say it's your turn. You go for the attack with your Crufsaw. And they're like, okay, Mirror Force. And you're like, oh, Tea Break. It doesn't go to the graveyard. So it's basically, it goes back to the hand, so they have a chance to reuse it. So it's like, oh, okay, that's not very good. But here's where it's good. If they Solemn Judgment something, and then you're like, Tea Break, they have to pay the half their life points. And then Judgment goes back to the hand. So they still have to pay the cost, which is amazing. So they're like, oh, warning. And you're like, Tea Break. And you're like, oh. I still have to pay 2,000, so it's like you get a free 2,000 off their life point. It's like a burn, for the most part, but it's very situational. The card's not very good. I mean, it's good, like, but you can't really like, oh, black dark hole, oh, tea break, okay, dark hole. So it's like, oh, it's not good in that aspect. So you're probably gonna run your judgment. Better card, Dark Bribe. I mean, they go plus. Well, no, they go even actually, because you get to negate the effect. But still, anyways. And that's about it. Now cards you can use with this deck are pretty situational. I mean, obviously you're gonna run your Dark Hole, Heavy Storm, Reborn. I run two Space Typhoons, two Dualities, two Bottomless Trap Holes, the Solemns, obviously. Two Starlights. I mean, you do run a little bit of back row, especially with Chateau and Ticket, which you wanna stay around, so you definitely should run a Starlight Road. You can run a Huge Revolution is over if you would like. I prefer Starlight Road. Stardust Dragon's amazing. So there's that. And then the best card you can run with this is Ultimate Offering, because you can just keep going off with your cards. Go, okay, go Magiline. Okay, add a Magiline. Okay, normal summon Magiline again. Okay, add another Magiline. Go net Magiline. Okay, overlay. Go for, what's the card? This card right here. It is Shockmaster. Go for Shockmaster. Okay, call spells. Okay, game over. I mean, you need it's slower because you do need to have Ultimate Offering, and Ultimate Offering is at one. But still, it's like, oh, okay, Magiline, Magiline, Magiline. Okay, now Mewfell, Messenger Lotto, Bounce Mag, Mewfell, Birdman. So I mean, it's good if you can get Ultimate Offering off plus Ticket plus Chateau. You shouldn't lose. You unless they have Logia, because Logia just trumps pretty much everything. But they only can Logia one thing. Oh, excuse me while I stretch. Oh, I was very uncomfortable. Okay. So that's pretty much what I run in my deck. And Birdman. Birdman for the synchros. And plus, Birdman does not go to the graveyard, he's banished. So, oh. Well, yeah, because you're going to bounce back a card, and then it'll get banished by Birdman effect. So there we go. There's that. Okay. Now, let's go over two. Okay, let's go over this card, Pudding Cess, real quick. Pudding Cess is, while you have no cards in your graveyard, this card gains 100 to 800 attack. So it comes 1800, 2300 with the PLS field spells, watch out for that. And then, after damage calculation, when this card battles an opponent's monster, you can target one card your opponent controls, destroy that target. So you may think, well, 1800, 2300, that's not that very good against the meta. Well, if you run up a safe zone, Pudding Cess can't be destroyed. Excuse me, I burp in like everything I do. You can basically attack into whatever you want, no fear, and then you still take damage. But you still get to pop a card at the end, using the effect. So that's amazing. So if you're running a Pudding Cess build, which you'd be running Tea Break, Pudding Cess, yada yada yada, you should run Safe Zone. Safe Zone's good with Pudding Cess. It's amazing with Pudding Cess. At least I believe. I mean, I'm not totally sure. And then another card you could run is Guardian Eidos. Probably not so much, because if Eidos dies, it does go to the graveyard, and then it's like your Pudding Cess play is over. Unless you can figure out a way to get the card out of the graveyard. But if you have no monster in your graveyard, you can special summon this card from your hand. So I mean, if you draw an Eidos, okay, Eidos, 2500 beater. It's not bad in Medulces, but if it does get destroyed, you have a Guardian Eidos in the graveyard. And this isn't just not Medulces, this is all monsters. So there's that. But okay, so that's other cards you could run in this build. Pudding Cess is you basically remove a couple Crafts-ons. You remove two Crafts-ons, throw in two Pudding Cesses, throw in safe zones. You just kind of like condense that. You remove the Birdmans. Definitely remove the Birdmans if you're going to run a Pudding Cess build, because the synchros do go to the graveyard if you end up synchroing up. I know Birdman's good in that aspect because you don't have cards in the graveyard, but the synchros do go to the graveyard. Now, the final Medulce card is Medulce Queen Tiramisu. Now, the thing with Medulce Queen Tiramisu is she does not have the effect where she gets shuffled back into the deck or extra deck. Well, she doesn't get shuffled back into the deck because she can't go to the deck. So therefore, she doesn't get that effect. But she requires two level 4 Medulce monsters, and once per turn you can attach one XYZ material from this card, then target up to two Medulce cards into your graveyard. Shuffle those targets into the graveyard, then shuffle cards your opponent controls into the deck up to the number of cards you return. The great thing about this is it does not target. Therefore, cards that say, oh, when a card is targeted, negate it. Because Medulce Queen Tiramisu does not target cards in the field. It just sends them to the deck. I mean, you have to click on them and dealing network, but it does not target. So you just pick two, they go to the deck. Now, Medulce cards, not monsters. So you can go Chateau, Tickets, Palooza, Tea Break, yada yada yada, shuffle them into the deck, target two, send them back. She's 2700 with the field spell. So there's that, and she works well with Chateau because if you go Oh-Hey, Magiline, Magiline, you get add two Magilines back to your hand because of Chateau. But that's pretty much it. I mean, obviously, if you're on Starlight Road, you want two Stardust. With Birdman, I like to run a Catastrophe. You really, Caster is probably the hardest thing to get out. You get really, actually, you can't get it out. You need to run Veiler, and I do not run Veiler. I just realized that. I'm an idiot. This is why this is for noobs. Black Rose, because it's like, oh, Butlerusk, Birdman, level 7. Scrap Dragon, if you can get it out, this one's a lot harder. It's level 8, Birdman's 4. You're gonna have to get Crufsun up 2 levels, Birdman, and then you can get out Scrap Dragon, which isn't bad. And then, obviously, Utopia. I run Excalibur because Messenger Lotto is a warrior, so it's not gonna happen often, but I'd rather have the 4000 beater if I can, because not a lot of high attacking monsters. Leviathan for level 3s, Shockmaster for the Magellans, because Magellan's amazing. Vylon Disigma, not very good compared to Shockmaster, but it's situational. I mean, if they're like, oh, here's a Graffa, well, I'll Vylon Disigma that, and that's pretty good, because then I'll have their Graffa now. Tyrus, Carrier Progenitors, is if you're running the Pudding Cess build, because they're level 5s, and Tyrus is amazing. I'm not going over the fact, because I think I'm running out of time for the most part, but I guess I'll go over the effect. Wow, this is awkward. I need to get on track. I keep getting sidetracked. This card's effect can only be applied to such drawables as it has XYZ material. This card cannot be destroyed by card effects. At the end of the battle phase, this card attacker was attacked. Target one card your opponent controls, destroy that target. So basically, can't be destroyed. It's like putting Cess. Okay, this card is basically putting Cess with safe zone for 2 turns. So, pretty decent, I guess. And then at the end of the phase, it loses the material. But, and then I run a Locomotion Argenx because it makes more sense to me because the Medocha cards aren't that high in attack. So if you can get this out, you can take their high attacking monster. Of course, it's highest level, but their highest level should be their highest attack per se, or close enough to it. So they get that. So I feel like, okay, run this. You have a Genex tuner. It makes sense to me. And then I run a Zen Mains. I don't run Tour Guide or anything like that because obviously it would put cards in the graveyard. All these cards put cards in the graveyard. There's no way to get rid of these unless you run only thing I know of personally. I mean, there's obviously something more. Is Soul Release, which is select 5 cards from the graveyard and remove them from play. But obviously there's something else there. But anyways, that is pretty much Modulce in a nutshell. Two different builds. You got Pudding Cess, which is about keeping Pudding Cess alive and popping cards that your opponent controls, but you take damage, so it's like you gotta have something in the bag. You have to have something ready to go, is what I'm trying to say there, because you can't just sit with Pudding Cess in safe zone. And you have Cruft's Knot build, which is building up a little puppy to immense power. Other cards are Chevalier, which is your opponent can't target face up Modulce monsters for attacks. It's good, but it doesn't really, synergize with the deck very well. So, and there's Bapple, which is another beast you can run, and it's basically target 2 cards in attack mode, switch them to defense mode. So you can go, oh, wait, normal summon Bapple, oh, I switch to defense, and it's like, okay. And there's a couple more. There's Waltz, which every time you Modulce monster you control attacks or is attacked, after damage calculation, inflict 3 damage to your opponent. It's all right. Palooza, Tea Break. Oh, and there's Lesson. Target one Modulce monster in your graveyard, shuffle that target into the deck, and if you do, all Modulce monsters you currently control gain 800 attack and defense. Then you can shuffle one other monster from your graveyard into the deck. It's all right. It's if you accidentally get cards into the graveyard. Oh, that actually works. If you get a Synchro in the graveyard, you can target one other. But you have to have Modulce in the graveyard, monster-wise, and that's hard to do, because you're not usually gonna sack. I don't know. It's hard to get Modulce in the graveyard to activate this card. That's all I'm saying. But I think that does it for Modulces for now. I mean, if more support comes out, I'll definitely look into it. For the most part, I think. Let me see here. Yeah, the most expensive cards are gonna be Magellin and the XYZ and Pudding Cess, which will run you a pretty penny. So there is that. So if you're looking to build this deck, Magellin is probably gonna cost you the most. The rest of the cards aren't too bad. They're like, oh, they're the commons of the deck. So Magellin will probably run you the most, I would say. Field spell not too bad. The field spell you only need 2 of, I would say. You don't need to run 3 of these. So I would say if you're looking to build this, go with the Magellins first and then work from there, because Magellin is the core of the deck. If whatever, no matter what you're running, Magellin's the core. You need to have 3 Magellins if you want to run this deck. But I think that's it. I think that's going to be a wrap for episode 1. Not even an episode. It's just like a little mini segment, I guess. Not really mini, it's been forever. But besides the point, guys, if you enjoyed the video, I guess you enjoyed it. I'm not asking. Haha. Anyways, guys, that'll do it for now, and I will see you all later. Later. I'm gonna go with later. I still have not thought of an outro. I'll think of something. Just you wait. Just you wait.